Hello, my dear students. A very good morning to all of you. So, in the previous class, we were discussing about the views of slide. In that, we have seen the four different ways in which we can view our slides. So, which were they? First was the normal view. Second was the slide shorter view. Third was the reading view. And the last was the slide show view. So today we will start with the topic of saving a presentation. So first let us understand why it is required to save any presentation. After we have written our presentation, we have seen how it looks in different views. So now it is turn to save it. Why? Because we can use it later on when required. So the steps to save our presentations are given below. First is you can go to the file menu button and choose either a save or a save as option from it. After that you have to type the name for the file in the save as dialog box and finally click on the save button to save it. Let us see it practically how it is possible. So here you can see that on the screen various tabs or various buttons will be available here. You have to select the first button, that is a file menu button. When you will click on the file menu button, like this, different options will be shown to you. So you have to select either the first, that is the save option, or the save as option. So now, what is the difference between save and save as? If you have already saved your document, but again you want to save it at the another location, at the different location and with the different name, then you have to use the second option, that is the save as option. But if you are saving a presentation for the very first time, then you have to use this first option, that is a save option. So here we are saving our presentation for the very first time. So which option we will use? We will use the first option, that is a save option. So first, by going to the file menu button, select the first option, that is a save option. And like this, save as dialog box will be appeared in front of you. Now you have to select the location where you want to save your file, whether you want to save it on desktop, in download, in C drive, in E drive, in F drive, in D drive. So you have to browse your location. You have to search your location first where you want to save your file. After searching it, you have to type here the name of your presentation. For example, here the person have written my first presentation. You can write any name you want your file to be saved. After typing a name, click here on the save button and your presentation will be saved by the name given by you. Okay, so this is how you can save your presentation. So this is only not the one way of saving a presentation. You can save a presentation in three different ways. Which are they? First, we have seen by going to the file menu button and selecting the save option. Second is from the quick access toolbar, select this sign. So this square box is a save button. And the third one is by pressing Ctrl plus S from the keyboard. Which are the three ways in which you can save a presentation, students? The first is going to the file menu button and selecting the save option. Second is selecting the save button, which is available in the quick access toolbar. And third is using Ctrl plus S from the keyboard. So here let us know something more. Save your presentation at the desired location by clicking on the drop down menu in the address bar by selecting the location. Second is you can also save the presentation by clicking on the save button in the quick access toolbar. And third is press Ctrl plus S keys to save a presentation from the keyboard. Okay, and here one do and learn activity is given to you. So just refer it. Let us move towards the keyword. First is clip art. So what is a clip art? A collection of the pictures or the graphic files is known as a clip art. Second is presentation. A collection of slides is known as presentation. Third is slide. A single screen in a PowerPoint presentation is known as a slide. And next is theme. A set of colors, fonts, and special effects are known as a theme. Okay, so with this, we are finishing our chapter today. These keywords you have to write in your computer notebook. Along with it, I am going to share the PDF of all the exercises with you. So this descriptive exercises along with the keywords you have to write in your computer notebook, while the textual exercises you can write in your computer textbook. Okay students, so now we will meet again next Monday with a new chapter or with a revision. Okay, so for now, bye-bye. Have a great day ahead.